Hello and welcome to another Every Tuesday video. This week we're going to change course a little bit and talk about passive income because as creatives working digitally, we have this massive opportunity to create passive income online or a nice side income. So first of all, passive income is creating artwork once, like a digital item, like a greeting card or a stationery template. You put in the work once, you list it for sale, and it can keep selling over and over and over again. So it can be really powerful the more items that you have. So I want to talk today about how font making changed my life with passive income. So in order to talk about how font making really changed my life, it helps to give you a little bit of context. So I'm going to give you some background on myself and how I got started with passive income. So hopefully you can see all of the possibilities for yourself with making extra income online from your artwork. So how I learned about passive income. The year was 2009. I had graduated in 2008 from the Savannah College of Art and Design. I got my bachelor's degree and I was working at my very first job out of school. I had $30,000 in student loans. I was making $30,000 a year as a junior designer and I was living by myself and paying $800 a month in rent just north of Atlanta. So with all this in mind, a little extra money could go a really long ways for me. So I was trying to figure out ways that I can make extra income without having to freelance constantly. So right around then is when I learned about Graphic River. And Graphic River was one of the very first digital online goods marketplaces to spring up. And between 2009 and 2014, I started making items. And I was making stationery items, design templates, textures, all kinds of different things. But I hadn't really figured out what my thing really was, but I just kept on creating more and more items. And it helped pay some of my utility bills every month, so that was really awesome. I was definitely making a side income, but I hadn't really figured out what my thing was. And it wasn't enough income where I could quit my job and actually do it full time. So I was constantly looking for a way to increase my online earnings without having to freelance. So that's how I learned about passive income, and now I want to talk to you about how I got serious about hand lettering. So in 2011, I had the great opportunity to attend the National Stationery Show in New York City, and if you don't know what it is, it's beyond eye candy for a designer that loves stationery. So it's a bunch of different greeting card and stationery companies that show off all of their goods in hopes of making wholesale contacts in the industry. So there's all kinds of booths with different stationery goods that you can walk around and really check everything out. And it is amazing. I would highly recommend it. So while I was there, I noticed all the different stationery goods that were using hand lettering. And I had always loved hand lettering, but I hadn't gotten really, really into it because I didn't know how it would play into my big future. Like, how was I going to use hand lettering to quit my job and work for myself full time? That was my ultimate goal, and I just didn't see how that could happen, so I kind of abandoned it. But once I went to the stationery show, I just fell in love with all the hand lettered goods, and I was like, you know what? I don't care if it plays into my big picture or not. I love hand lettering, and I want to get better at it. So I went full force after that, and I just started practicing every single day, trying to improve my hand lettering. This is some of my really early stuff, and I just practiced. And soon my lettering really improved. I noticed a huge difference in my lettering the more that I practiced. So practicing as much as possible whenever possible. So between 2011 and 2015, that's all I did, just on my own, not trying to make money at all, just practicing because I love to do it. And in late 2014, because I was selling on Graphic River, a new marketplace started opening up and it was called Creative Market. And around late 2014, hand lettered fonts started appearing on Creative Market. And right then is when the light bulb popped on for me. I knew what I had to do. I knew how hand lettering was going to play into my big picture. It was time for me to learn hand lettered font making. So in the fall of 2015, I sat down to teach myself font making, not knowing what I was getting into, not knowing how hard it would be or how easy it would be. I just knew I wanted to make hand lettered fonts because it married that idea of passive income where I couldn't figure out how to really make it work with templates and my love for hand lettering. The two went so perfectly together. I just felt so pulled in that direction that no matter how long it was going to take, I was going to learn how to create hand-lettered fonts. So by January of 2016, I released my very first font. It was called Tuesday Script, and I started selling it. But it took me 6 months from the time I first sat down to teach myself to when I released Tuesday Script. That was 6 months that I spent teaching myself and trying to learn just how to make a font. So it took another 6 months after that for me to feel really confident using the font software. I learned a bunch of new tricks after that. I learned how to use the software a lot better. So about a year in, and I felt really confident with making fonts. A year of my life just to learn how to make a font. And during the entire process of creating my first font, I was so frustrated that there was such a lack of resources for learning font making online that it felt like this huge secret that other font creators wanted to keep. That way they could be more competitive. And I just got so upset and so frustrated because it should have been easier than it was for me. I mean, it took me an entire year and I really felt like I needed to do something about it. So my first year creating and selling hand-lettered fonts, I made $40,000 just in font sales alone. And you may be thinking, yeah, but font selling is too saturated now than it was when you got started. And you're right, it is. And although there are more font makers now, well-executed fonts still create a healthy side income. And in 2017, just to prove that, I made $25,000 from font sales alone, just in 2017. And I had only created two new fonts. So I had five fonts total that I was selling in 2017. So even though there's more competition now, it is totally possible to still make a really healthy side income off of your fonts. So what this meant for me is that along with the other income that I was making from my other digital products, selling courses, and I had, you know, textures and templates and all the other things that I showed you previously online, I was able to quit my day job. And I didn't have to freelance unless I wanted to. I got to pick and choose which types of freelance opportunities I wanted to undertake. I didn't feel compelled to take jobs that maybe I wasn't as excited about just because I needed to pay the bills anymore. And I also had the freedom to create the art I've always wanted. I really lost with all the freelancing and all the full-time work that I had been doing previously. I really lost the opportunity to just sit down and experiment and create no matter what came of it. I just really loved that time to just sit down and create whatever I wanted. And I was able to have that time again to sit down and do that. I also was able to open up time to teach others how I made it all happen. Because of how frustrated I was when I was teaching myself, at that time I was teaching design online. I was doing my weekly tutorials, and I thought a great opportunity to share what I know and everything that I've learned through this really long process, this year of my life that it took just figuring everything out, I can share that and cut down that time for others. And now I can also share how to sell fonts too. So I decided to do it, and that's exactly what I did. So I created Learn Font Making, which is my online course to create professional and profitable hand-lettered fonts. I teach you not only how to create a font, I teach you how to sell it too, and all of my best tricks and strategies for font selling. And it's a proven process. Past students in the class have had great success with creating their own hand-lettered fonts, being able to type with their lettering for the first time ever, which is the most amazing feeling. And they're selling too. I only open up my course twice a year. And right now, if you're watching this in real time, I just opened it up for the first time this year. So if you head on over to learnfontmaking.com, you can see all the details, check out all the information, read past testimonials, and join in and learn how to create your own hand-lettered fonts. If you're watching this in the future, you can still visit learnfontmaking.com and just get on the list to be notified, and you'll get an email as soon as it reopens in the future. That link is also a clickable link right in the video description. So that's how font making changed my life with passive income and continues to change my life with opening up all these other possibilities, just opening up that time, that freedom to experiment and try new things and have that income on the side. With passive income, you create an item once and you can sell it over and over again, which is really amazing, especially for us as digital artists. So if you're interested in font making and creating a passive income stream, be sure to head on over to learnfontmaking.com.